welcome to Fantastic Science. Today, we are going to make a working model of the digestive system. But first, let's learn a little about digestion. All living things need food for energy and growth. Food is changed into energy through the process of digestion, which happens in the digestive system. In humans, the main organs of the digestive system are the mouth, the esophagus, the stomach, and the small and large intestines. Digestion starts in the mouth when we chew our food. Saliva also helps to break down the food. When we swallow food, it moves down the esophagus into the stomach. The stomach mixes the food with enzymes, which help to break down the food. This mixture is then pushed into the small intestine, where digestive juices and enzymes break the food down further into nutrients, which are good for us. These nutrients enter the body through the walls of the small intestine. The body then uses these nutrients for energy and growth. Some food, like plant fibers, cannot be broken down. These substances move from the small intestine into the large intestine and turn from a liquid into a solid. This is waste, or poop, which passes out of the body into the toilet. Now that you know what the digestive system is, let's see how it works. Let's take a look at what you will need. A small banana. A piece of bread. 30 milliliters of water. 30 milliliters of orange juice. A potato masher. A bowl. A spoon. A zip seal bag. A pair of scissors. And one leg from a pair of tights. Let's get started. Step 1. In a bowl, gently crush the bread and banana with a potato masher. This is like food being chewed in the mouth. Step 2. Spoon the crushed food into a zip seal bag, which is the stomach. Add the water and orange juice. The water represents saliva, and the orange juice represents stomach acid. Make sure there is no air in the bag, and seal it. Crush the bread and banana by gently squeezing the bag. This represents the food breaking down further inside the stomach. Step 3. Once you have a thick liquid in the stomach, cut a small hole in a corner of the bag. Carefully squeeze it into the tights, which represent the small intestine. Did you know? The small intestine is between 6 to 7 meters long and is the longest part of the digestive system. Step 4. Hold the tights over the bowl and gently push the food down to the bottom. As you push, liquid will ooze out of the tights. Keep squeezing until no more liquid comes out. These are the nutrients that the body absorbs and uses. The food left behind in the tights represents the waste products in the large intestine that cannot be used or broken down by the body. Step 5. Cut a hole in the bottom of the tights. Squeeze the contents into the bowl. This is the waste, or poop, going into the toilet. We hope this helped you to understand how the digestive system works. Thank you for watching. See you all next time. Goodbye.